Today I'm gonna show you how to make battery equalizer, which also called battery balancer. Every time when you connect two batteries in series together, you will find that the voltage of one of them is higher than the other. For example, in my case, the voltage of the first battery is 14.4 volt, while the other is 13.9 volts. These unbalanced voltages can decrease in the lifespan of the batteries, because when you charge them together, one of them get fully charged while the other stay not charged. To solve in this problem, we have to use in battery equalizer. There are two different types of battery equalizer, passive and active. The passive type is very simple. It just discharges the battery with higher voltage until the voltage of both batteries become exactly the same. But in the active type, we use the excessive energy that is stored in the battery with higher voltage to charge the other battery with less voltage. In this video, I just make the passive one, and the active type for another video, maybe in the future. This is my circuit. This circuit consists of differential amplifier, window comparator, resistor voltage divider as voltage reference, and some switching MOSFET to connecting the dummy load to the batteries. I use the voltage drop across the diode as voltage reference. After using resistor voltage divider, the voltage here will be plus 10 mV and here minus 10 mV. Then I connect these two voltages to the upper limit and lower limit of the window comparator. I use this differential amplifier to find out the voltage difference between the two batteries. In the normal situation, when the voltage of both batteries are exactly the same, let's say 12 volt each of them, the voltage here will be 12 volt and the output voltage from the resistor voltage divider also 12 volt. So the output voltage of the differential amplifier will be 0 volt. In that case, the voltage of this op amp will be low, because the voltage of inverting input, which is 0 volt, is higher than the voltage of non-inverting input, which is minus 10 mV. The output voltage of the second op amp will be low as well, because of the same reason. But if the voltage of the first battery was higher than the other, let's say 12.1 volt and the other 12 volt, in that case the voltage at this point will be 12 volt and the voltage at this point will be 12.05 volt. So differential amplifier calculate the voltage difference between these two points and multiply it by 2. The output voltage here will be 100 millivolts. This time the output of this op amp will be high, because the voltage of non-inverting input is higher than the voltage of inverting input. So it is switched on this MOSFET and start to discharging this battery that has higher voltage. It is stay discharged until the voltage of both batteries become exactly the same. The same thing happen if the voltage of the second battery was higher. You can use unity gain for this differential amplifier. The gate of this MOSFET needs to protection, because according to the datasheet, the maximum voltage between the gate and source could be plus minus 20 volt. And since the voltage here is more than 24 volt, so it needs to protection. But the other MOSFET don't need to protection, because the source of that MOSFET already connected to 12 volts. So by connecting the gate to 24 volt, the voltage difference between the gate and source stay 12 volts. I converted this circuit to PCB and ordered it from PCBWay.com. After a few months, I received my package. Then I soldered the components on the PCB. To simulate in two batteries in series, I just connect two power supply together as shown here. When the voltage of both power supplies are exactly the same, nothing happen. But when I increasing the voltage of one of them, this circuit start to drawing current to discharge it. So the circuit working well. After making sure that the circuit working well, I connect it to my solar batteries. And as you can see, it start to drawing current from the battery that has higher voltage to discharge it. After a few minutes, I found that the temperature of the dummy load resistor become extremely high. As you can see here, it is about 200 degrees Celsius. And it also burnt the PCB. I used 75 watt power resistor. According to my calculation, the power dissipation is less than 40 watts. So the problem is not from the resistor itself, but because there are no proper heat sink around it. To solve this problem, I put my circuit inside a metal enclosure. and use it as a heatsink to cool down the resistors and the MOSFETs. By the way, you have to use thermal pad for the MOSFETs. Otherwise, you can short out them together. I test it again to make sure it stay working well and connect it to the batteries again. This time the maximum temperature drops to 60 degrees. The interesting thing here that sometimes the battery number 1 has higher voltage and some other times the battery number 2 has higher voltage. The reason for that because the real capacity of battery number 1 is slightly less than the battery number 2. Let's say the first battery is 195 amps hour and the other is 200 amps hour. So that means when you charge them together, the first battery get fully charged before than the other. But when you start to discharge them, this time the voltage of the first battery drops faster than the other because it has less capacity and drain faster. After using this circuit for my batteries for a few days, I found that the voltage of these two batteries become very close to each other. To be honest with you, I have to say that this circuit has two problems. The first problem that the 2 amps or 3 amps that this circuit is drawing from your battery is very low in compared to the battery capacity, so it takes a long time to equalize your batteries. The second problem that it can produce a lot of heat. The active type battery equalizer has higher efficiency. Maybe I can make it for another video. I did some changes on this PCB and you can order it from PCBWay.com. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.